Yes, good morning children. Today let us see a few alicyclic compounds and how to name them, okay? Now these are all cyclic compounds and they are all called as alicyclic. Aromatic means it should be having a benzene ring, right? Basically. Even those which do not contain a benzene ring, they are also considered as aromatic. That we will see a little later, okay? In the next chapter we will see. Now what is this? This is cyclopropane. This is cyclobutane, this is cyclopentane, this is cyclohexane. Okay, now this is called as cyclopentene. It's also having 5 carbon atoms and there is a double bond. So obviously the number will be between 1 and 2. So you just have to name it as cyclopentene. It automatically, it is taken for granted that the double bond is between 1 and 2. Then this is cyclopentadiene. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So cyclopentadiene, when you say, then you have to number the carbon. So it is cyclopenta 1, 3, diene. Is that clear? Cyclopenta 1, 3, diene. That means the double bond is between 1 and 2 and the other double bond is between 3 and 4. So you call it as this. Then this is called as cyclohexene. Okay. Now what is this called? This is called as 1,2-dimethylcyclopentane. 1,2-dimethylcyclopentane. Then what is this called? Now this is called as now here, see, this is cyclopentane which is having 5 carbon atoms and this chain is having 4 carbon atoms. Okay, so what you will do, you will name it, I mean the chain and the ring, whichever is having higher number of carbon atoms, you will call it as a derivative of that name. That means here you will call it as a derivative of cyclopentane, not that of butane. Because butane mein 4 carbon hai, pentane mein 5 carbon hai. Is it not? So you will call this as see, if you take it this way, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the long chain. Then in that case, this will be 2-cyclopentylbutane. That's how you will call it. Okay. Or what you can do is, see, this is a 4 carbon chain. And in that 4 carbon chain, at the second position, there is a methyl group. So you consider it this way. If I show it like this, CH, CH2, CH3. And there is a CH3 here. How you will call it as 1-methylpropyl, is it not? 1-methylpropyl you call it as. So you can also call it as 1-methylpropyl cyclopentane. Okay. You can also call it as 1-methylpropyl cyclopentane. You can also call it like this. Okay. Or you can also call it as 2-cyclopentylbutane. Okay, you can call it that way also. Okay, 2-cyclopentylbutane. This way also you can call it. Generally, this is preferred. Then what is this called? This is called as dicyclopropyl methane. This is called as dicyclopropyl methane. Why it is so? Because this is considered as CH4. CH4 mein ek hydrogen ko 1 cyclopropyl, another hydrogen is replaced by another cyclopropyl. So you call it as dicyclopropyl methane. You call it as a derivative of methane. Now, how do you call this? This is called as 1, 2, 3. So, this is 3-cyclopropyl-prop-1-ene. Okay? 3-cyclopropyl-prop-1-ene. You can call it like this. right? Now you may ask, now this is also containing three carbon atoms, this is also containing three carbon atoms, why we should call it as a derivative of propene? That is because a functional group is there, double bond is there, so this will be given the preference as a substituent only, and this you have to name it as a main chain. Okay, that is why it is 3-cyclopropyl-prop-1-ene. Now again, in this also, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4-cyclohexyl, then butte, 3-ene-2-one. This is how you will name it. At the fourth position, cyclohexyl is there. Then in this chain, you are having between 3 and 4 a double bond, and then this is ketonic group. So you will call it like this. Then how do you name this? This is named as, this is numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 1-methyl-cyclopentene. When you don't number, that means the double bond is between 1 and 2. When you don't number, you can call it as 1-methyl-cyclopent-1-ene also you can say. Okay, there's nothing wrong with it. Pent, you can call it as 1-ene also. Right? Then, this is called as cyclohexanone. Right? This is called cyclohexanone. Now, how do you call this? This is called as, this is derivative of ketone, is that this thing, main functional group. So you call this as, now this is given secondary, so you call it as, this is number 1, 2, 3. So 3-hydroxycyclohexanone. 3-hydroxycyclohexanone, you call it like this, okay. Then, how would you name this? Now, see, this is an interesting feature here. 1, 2, 3, 4. By numbering it like this, you will get OH group at the second position. If you number from here, it will get at the third position. So you'll have to number it like this. So at the first position, what you are having? You are having a cyclohexane attached, and that cyclohexane is having 1-hydroxyl group. Okay. Now, look at the side chain. The side chain is having 4 carbon atoms and the ring chain is having 6 carbon atoms. So the rule, what it says, and both of them are having the same functional group. This is also OH, this is also OH. So that's, both of them are having the same importance. So in that case, what you have to understand, what you have to consider, that chain which is having more number of carbon atoms is given preference. That means the cyclohexane ring is given preference, or not this butane chain. Okay, so in that case, what you will write, you will call this as at the second position. See, this is, I told you this, you have to number it as a derivative of the cyclohexane. So this is number 1 and this is number 2. At the second position of the cyclohexane ring, this chain is there. Okay, so what you will do, first you will put this 2 at the second position. What you are having, you are having 2-hydroxybutyl, okay, this is 2-hydroxybutyl, bracket band karo, then cyclohexane 1-ol, okay. So remember, when you are having the same functional group and you have to choose how to write the name, in that case, you have to call it as a derivative of that chain which is having more number of carbon atoms. If this was also, say, 6, then there may be a confusion. But if it is 4, then it is significantly, this is more. So you have to call it as a derivative of the cyclohexane. Okay, I'll have to find out if both the sides are the same, then what do you have to do? I'll tell you. Okay, then how about this? This is called as, so again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and this is made up of only 1, 2, 3. So this side chain is having only 3 carbon atoms, and this is having 6 carbon atoms. But you see here, the principal functional group is here. So obviously you have to name it as a derivative of propionic acid only. Okay, so how will you name this? This you will name it as this group is attached to which position of this chain? Iski third position pe attached hai. To sabse pehle 3 dalo, dalke, then at the fourth position you are having chlorine, so it is 4 chloro, then cyclo hex 1 in cyclohexenyl. Okay, you call it as cyclohexenyl, then close the bracket, then prop 2 in 1 oic acid. Okay, prop 2 in 1 oic acid. Okay, so this just like alkyl, same way this is hexenyl. Okay, now what about this? Now if you 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Okay, so how will you name this? Four cyclohexyl, then three methyl butene 2-ol. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the chain. This is having the principal functional group, so you will have to call it as a derivative of 1, 2, 3, not butanol, it is propen 2-ol. ठीक है, 4 cyclohexyl. फोर भी कैसे होगा, थ्री के साथ अटैच होगा, थ्री साइक्लोहेक्साइल, थ्री मिथाइल प्रोपेन टू ऑल. यस, ओके, देन कम टू द लास्ट वन. नाउ दिस इज अगेन, दिस इज हैविंग द प्रिंसिपल फंक्शनल ग्रुप, सो दिस इज नंबर्ड एज 1, 2, 3. And this ring, you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this will be numbered as 2 from here. Then open the bracket. Cyclopent 3 enyl propanol. Okay, so this is how you will number.